Welcome to today's St. Anthony's classes. Today our topic is finding square root through repeated subtraction. And I assure you that after attending the session without missing any part of the session, you will better understand the better understanding about square root through repeated subtraction. So I request you not to wait till the end of the session. Now itself, press the like button as well as the subscription button. And now let us start. Suppose the first odd natural number, that is one. Okay, first odd natural number one, and we are adding the next odd natural number to this, that is 1 plus 3, we are getting 4. So what does 4 means? 2 into 2, it means 2 square. 2 into 2 means 2 square. Now I am adding one more number to this 1 plus 3, to the next natural number. Next natural number is 5, so I am getting here 9. 9 means 3 into 3, that is 3 square. Now I am adding one more number, next number to the 5, the odd natural number I am adding here, that is 7. When I am adding the 7 here, then I will get 16. 16 means 4 into 4, that is 4 square. Now let us add 9 to this one. 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7, and next number is 9, I am adding. So I am getting here 25. What does means 25? 25 means 5 into 5, that is 5 square. So if you add the next number, that is the 11, next odd number is 11, then you are going to get 36, that is the square of 6. What does it mean? It means that the sum of the first n odd natural number is n square. It means the sum of first n odd natural number numbers is n square. So we got this first n odd natural number is n square. That means every square number can be expressed as a sum of successive odd natural number starting from 1. I repeat, every square number can be expressed as a sum of successive odd natural numbers starting from 1. It means the reverse also should satisfy. If we are adding the number starting from 1, and we are getting the square, it means that when we start to minus the number, then we should get the number also from the square of a number. If we are minusing the odd natural number starting from 1, then we are supposed to get the square root of that particular number. Whether we are getting it or not, that we will see here. Now, suppose we have to find the square root of 81. So 81 we are having here. First, I am going to minus the first odd natural number, that is 1, from 81. So what I will get here? Here I will get 80. Here I am going to get 80. In second step, 80 is there with us, with the first case. Then I am going to minus the next odd natural number, that is 3. So here I will get 77. Now in step 3, I am minusing from 77 the next odd number 5. So I will get 72. Then as the fourth step, from 72 minus 7, because 7 is the next odd number, so we are going to get 65. In fifth step, we are minusing from 65, 9. So we are getting 56. In seventh step, from 56, we are minusing 11. So we are getting 45 here. Now in step 8, 45 minus, which is the next number from the 11, that is 13. I am minusing 13, so I am getting 32. Now, here step 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, here it is 6 only step, and this step is 7. So we are getting the step here 7. Okay, now step 8 is 32 minus 15. So we are getting 17. And in 9th step, 17 minus 17 will come. So we are getting 0. Okay, now see how many steps it has been taken from 1 to 9. It means with the 9th step, it becomes 0. So how many steps it will take, that much will be the number. Square root of 81. Square root of 81 will be the number of steps, that is 9. So this is satisfying. Now let us consider another number. Another two number we will consider. As example number 2, root of 100 and root of 169 we have to do. So let us take the first case, 100 first. Here we are taking 100 first. So first step is 100 minus 1, that we are getting 99. In second step, we will keep on minusing the next odd number is 3, so we are going to get 96 over here, and next number we will minus from here, 96 minus 5, so we will get 91. And in fourth step, 91, next number is 7, 91 minus 7 is coming as 84. Then fifth case, 84 minus 9, we have to minus, so we will get 75. And in sixth step, from 75, next number is 11, so we are getting 64. Now seventh step, 64 minus 13. So we are getting here 51. Now eighth step, 51 minus 15. So we are getting here 36. And in ninth step, 36 minus 17, we will get 19 here. And now we are coming to the 10th step, 19, next number is 19, so we are getting 0. It means that the square root of 100, we have come to 0 at the 10th step. It means 10 is the square root of 100. Then one more number is there, that also we will check. It is 169. So we are following the same way, 169 minus 1, we are having 169. 8. Then second step we are taking 168, then minusing 3, so we are getting 165. Then in next step 165 minus 5, it means 160. And in fourth stage, 160 minus 7, we will get 153. And fifth is 153 minus 9. So we are getting 144. And sixth step, 144 minus 11, we are getting 133. And in seventh step, 133 minus 13, we are getting 120. And in eighth step, 120 minus 15, we are getting 105. And in ninth step, 105 minus 17, so we are getting 88. And in 10th step, 88, we are taking the next odd number and minus it, then we will get 69. Then 11th stage, 69 minus 21, so we are getting 48. Now 12th stage, 48 minus 23, we will get 25. And in 13, 25 minus 25, we are getting 0. So we can say here, 13 step have taken. So 169 square root is 13. And if you are interested, please do this. Find the square root of 625 and find the square root of 121. If you are interested, you can do this. Okay, hope you could understand it very well. And if you have forgot to press the like button as well as the subscription button, please do it. And that way encourage us. Thank you for attending the session.